permanently live. You probably are too. From the light that shines in the darkness, I need my next fix, my next hit, 110 times a day, 3 hours a day is the average amount of time spent. A light children see from the time they are born. They see adults looking like robots see. It's what they adore. They find the norm, but without it, they get bored. A light in the darkness leading them nowhere, creating a stronger addiction for the next generation. No kids outside, I guess, play in imagination or on a permanent vacation. The outdoors has lost its fascination and alteration to the very definition of being a kid. Gone are the days when we pick up our babies when they're crying and sad. Nowadays, we just hand an iPad glad. Are we when they're crying and stop to make convenience with us? A TV, a laptop, a tablet, a phone, a light in the darkness, Wi-Fi, 4G, LTE, away or at home. 46% of my I generation finds this as their source of happiness. How have we come to this? We're connected with no real connection, creating depression off of false perfection and assumed perception seen on every social media screen with every finger scroll. Dentate rocket scientists know that we're an overstimulated culture looking for love disguised as a life. Our humanity is slipping, we must rise above and fight this addiction and knowing love, people hug them, look them in their eyes, apart from this affliction. See, God says it's not good for man to be alone. Therefore, he created Eve for Adam. He did not give Adam a new iPhone. You see, a lack of family values aren't the reason marriages don't last these days. Couples eat by their phones and bed with them they lay. Instead of touching, holding hands, conversating over dinner, they're streaming, scrolling, updating, uploading, comparing who's thinner, who's richer. We have a finite existence, a set number of days. Christ came and we have life that is abundant. Therefore, it is incumbent upon us as Christians to distance ourselves, to take part in the resistance on refusing to bow down to God, technology, to seek mercy for seeking answers from an Apple product named Siri, for seeking the empty light of the screen, instead of the true light of the world who died just for you, who died just for me. Like any good thing, when abuse becomes sin, it's an apple that destroys at the beginning. Will it be an apple in the end?